Have you ever needed to copy a bunch of cells, like numbers or dates down in Excel, and you thought you had to hand enter them all to get it in? There's a really easy way to do it, and it's called, there's two different ways actually. One is fill and one is a formula called sequence. So I'm going to show you them very quickly. I'm Tina, your sassy efficiency expert with excelling your business. And let's get to it. Let's teach you how to do these so you don't have to waste any more time getting these done. All right, so the first one is really just a fill. You type in the one or whatever number, type in a one, and you can copy it down. So right now it's just copying down to 20. And you can see it just put in ones. So I'm going to come back here and I'm going to do a one again. But this time when I click on that little square, you see my plus sign turned to a big black plus. I'm going to hold my control key down and see you get that other little plus just above it. If I let that go, it goes away. I'm going to drag that down this time. And you also can see in the bottom right corner, there's a count of how many I've got. So I'm going to let go of my mouse. And poof, I've got 20 there. Now, if I didn't really want the 20, I can go back to copy cells down in this little drop-down box, and it'll put the ones back in. But I do want the 20, so I'm going to go back to fill series. So another way you can do it is increments. So if I did a 5 and a 10, so you want to increment by 5 every time, I can do 5, 10, and I can drag this down. And it's going to go to 100. Again, same thing, I can copy the cells or I can fill that series. So one last time I'm going to do this the same thing, but I'm going to do it with sequence this time. And I'm going to do it a little bit bigger range. So I'm going to say equals the sequence, SEQ. And once I have that up there, if I hit my tab key, it automatically pulls it up, the rest of the formula. I'm going to do 500 rows because I want 500 numbers to come in. I only want it in one column, so when I put in my comma, I'm going to put a 1 for columns. I'm going to start at 100, and I'm going to do 100, now I'm going to do 50 in the step, so you'll see a 100, a 1, or a 50, I'm starting at 100, sorry about that. So you're going to see it go from 100, add 150. So if I really wanted to do this right, I would probably change this to 50 and start at 50 and then it will redo it. And now if I go down to the, oops, I didn't want to delete, I wanted to go end and down arrow, it'll bring me down to 500 rows. And that, see how quick that was instead of having to drag it all the way down and make sure you stop at the right spot. I'm going to do control home, that's going to bring me back to cell A1. Now these columns E, F, and G, and H, I already have formatted as a date. So I'm just going to type in 1-1, and it's going to bring in January 1st of the current year. So be careful at the end of the year when we jump into the new year. If you're entering December dates, it's going to go back, and it's going to put December 2023 coming in. So just be aware of that when you're around the change of the year, you might have to put in the date or the year. Okay, so I just drug that down and it filled in 20 different dates. Again, I can copy the cells. So this is an easy way that Excel does some of this work for you. You don't have to do this all. So again, if I wanted to go by 7 days, I can type in 1-1. And then I'm going to type in 1-8 because that's 7 days. And I'm just going to highlight both of them, make my cursor change to the black plus, and I'll go down to, go to the end of June. So that's about 26 weeks. Yep, that's 26 weeks exactly. So that's like 6 months. So let me do that again, but this time I'm going to use the sequence formula. And I am going to, so I'm going to say equals sequence, SEQ, I'm going to hit the tab. I'm going to do 26 rows because I still want it to count. I want to go a half a year. I want it in one column, so I'm going to put in a 1. And I'm going to say my start is going to be a date. So I'm going to type in DAT, and I'm going to hit date. My year is 2022. I'm going to start in November, and I'm going to start on the 30th. And I'm going to put in the closing parenthesis. I'm still on start. I got to put in a comma to put in my step, and I'm going to do 7 because I want it to jump by 7 days. So I'm doing every Wednesday for the next 6 months. So that brings me to 5/24. So 2 different ways to do things comes out the same depending on where you start. Might be a little bit easier. If I wanted to change this and I wanted to go to 52 weeks, oops, I got to be in the right cell. The formula is actually in the very first cell. It shows here, but you can see it's kind of grayed out. So these aren't actually a formula here. If I click on that cell, it shows there's nothing there. It's all coming from this first cell. So if I wanted to do 52 weeks, I can just change that right here, and my formula will now jump down for a year. So it's very quick and easy to change those. What I would probably do is then highlight that, if I can get to it. If I needed them to be actual dates, I would highlight that, copy, and paste special as values, because now they're dates. So that formula went away. I don't have the formula anymore. So those are some quick and easy tips on Excel on how you can quickly and easily add numbers or put numbers in, pull them down to be actual numbers, or, whoops, I did the wrong one there, or they can actually do dates, the same thing. So there's different ways you can use Excel to let Excel do more work for you, because the more you're doing manual work, the longer it's going to take, the more tedious it's going to be, the more errors you're going to have. I love making Excel work for you, because then you can do what you actually love to do. If you'd like to have a conversation, there's a free Excel support at the bit.ly link there. That is for a free consultation, 15 minutes, just chat, see how Excel could help you do your business more efficiently, because that's what I love to do. It brings joy to my heart to make you more efficient so you have more time to do what you love, because I know it's not the paperwork. Thank you and have a great day.